In this video, we cover the initial configuration of the PowerProtect Data Domain systems. Please note that the serial port at the rear of the system is the only supported interface for initial console access. As such, do not connect to the USB, VGA, or iDRAC direct micro USB port on the front of the system, or to the iDRAC 9 dedicated management port on the rear of the system. To begin, connect a DB9 null modem cable to the serial port at the rear of the PowerProtect DD system. Connect the system to the network via the 1 gigabit Ethernet port. The base system supports 4x10 gigabit Ethernet. For the purposes of this demonstration, we will connect only one 10 gigabit cable. Connect the power. The PowerProtect DD is a dual PSU system. Connect each PSU to a redundant AC power source. By using redundant power sources, it allows one AC source to fail or be serviced without impacting the system operation. Out of the box, the system will not automatically power on after plugging in AC power. You need to press the power button on the front of the system to continue. From the initial start, it can take up to 5 minutes for the system to begin to send messages to the serial console. Using a laptop attached to the DB9 serial cable you connected, launch a terminal emulation program such as PuTTY or HyperTerm, and configure the COM port you're connected to with the following communication settings: baud rate of 115200, data bits 8, stop bits 1, parity none, flow control none, and emulation VT100. Note, you must use 115200 baud rate for the system to work correctly. 9600 baud rate does not work. Press enter to activate the console. The system can take up to 15 minutes to complete the boot process. If you do not see the prompt on your terminal to log in, then verify the front blue LED is on. If it is not, make sure the power cables are fully seated at both ends and all the AC sources are on, then power on the system. If it is powered on, then verify that the DB9 cable is connected correctly and double-check the terminal settings. The initial username is sysadmin, and the initial password is a system serial number found on the hang tag attached to the rear handle of the chassis or on the pull tag on the front of the system. The PSNT is followed immediately by the text PN and a number that begins with 900. Log into the Data Domain console using the initial username and password. For configuration, there are two wizards: a Data Domain System Manager configuration wizard and a Command Line Interface configuration wizard. These configuration wizards guide you through a simplified configuration of the system to get the system operating quickly. The CLI Configuration Wizard starts automatically the first time the system starts. The wizard prompts you through a series of questions that provide just enough information for initial system configuration and basic network connectivity. You can also begin the CLI Configuration Wizard manually by typing config setup. After you complete the basic configuration in the CLI Wizard, you can switch to the GUI Configuration Wizard in Data Domain System Manager. Or you may also continue to use the CLI to further configure your system. Now for the initial network setup procedure using CLI. To configure the system for network connectivity, type yes. Depending on whether or not your network is set up with DHCP, the steps you perform may vary from our demonstration, which uses a static private network. For DHCP, you can type yes to configure DHCP to automatically obtain network parameters, such as host name, domain name, and IP addresses from a DHCP server, or type no to configure the parameters manually as we show in our demonstration. Type a fully qualified domain name for the host name, or accept the host name if your system can discover it. Type the DNS domain name, or accept the domain name if your system can discover it. Next, enable and configure each Ethernet interface. Accept or decline DHCP for each interface. If the port does not use DHCP to discover the network parameters automatically, type the information manually. Please note, additional ports beyond EthmA, EthmB, EthmC, and EthmD may not appear in your system depending on the optional NICs you have installed. Type the IP address of the default routing gateway, or accept the default gateway if your system can discover it. If you are using IPv6, type the IPv6 address of the default routing gateway, or accept the IPv6 address of the default gateway if the system can discover it. While if IPv6 is not in use, leave the field empty and press Enter to continue. Type up to 3 DNS servers to use for resolving host names to IP addresses, using a comma-separated or space-separated list. Press Enter for no DNS servers, or accept the IP addresses of the DNS servers if the system can discover them. A summary of the network settings is then displayed. You can accept the settings using the command Save, reject the settings and exit the CLI using Cancel, or return to the beginning of the current section and change the settings with Retry. Using Retry displays the previous responses for each prompt. To accept the displayed value, simply press Enter, or type a new one. At this point, you can use the Data Domain System Manager GUI to customize the setup to your backup environment. The GUI wizard guides you through adding license key files, configuring backup clients, file shares, and protocols. This completes our demonstration of the initial CLI setup of a PowerProtect Data Domain solution. For more information about setup and configuration processes for PowerProtect DD, visit support.emc.com.